Hello friends, today in this video I am going to show you how I created flower coloring book. So without any further delay, let's start the today's video. First of all, let's look at some of the books in this flower coloring book niche. So when we go to Amazon, we can see that there are different books that are doing really well in this niche. So we can see that this book is currently ranked at 1086 in the entire Amazon bookstore. So with this ranking, it is probably selling more than 3000 copies in just 1 month, and it is priced at $9.99. So this book is probably making more than $8000 in 1 month. So now let's head on to Canva and let's learn how to create this coloring book. So I am here in my Canva. This is the coloring book that I have created. So let's take a look at some of the pages of this book, so you can get the idea how you can arrange your own coloring book before we learn how to create our own coloring book. So as you can see, this is the front page, and I have added this copyright page here. So you can also add various different copyright disclaimers by adding a text box in this page. And this is the color test page, and it's pretty easy to create. You just have to copy various different rectangles and you will get this page. So the fourth page is left blank, and our coloring book starts from page number 5. So as you can see, this is the first page of our book. As you can see, I have added this quote in my coloring page. So you can also add various different quotes in your coloring book page, but make sure that you have got proper rights to use the quote. So you can find various different public domain quotes on the internet, so make sure to check that out. So let's take a look at the next page. So this page doesn't have any quote. It has got this beautiful flower in it. And again, we have got this next page here. So in this way, I have created various different coloring book pages. So now let's learn how we can create our own coloring book page. So now what we are going to do is, we are going to go to Canva. Let's go to this home page here, and let's create a new design of custom size 8.5 by 11 inches. The most widely used size of a coloring book page is 8.5 by 11 inches, and we are going to use these margins and borders, so we are not going to require any bleed here. So we are just going to create a document of size 8.5 by 11 inches. So before starting to create our coloring book, make sure to like this video. So today in this video, I'm going to show you an awesome tool where you can create your coloring book pages. So first of all, let's look at some of the images that we are going to use in our coloring book. So let's go to pixabay.com. Also, at the very end of the video, I'm going to show you a website where you can get free vector images that you can use in your coloring book. So make sure to watch this video till the very end. So let's take a look at some of the flowers in Pixabay. So what we are going to do is search in this vector graphics section, because we are concerned about vectors. So as you can see, various different vector graphics are available that you can use in your coloring book. You can use these black and white images without any modifications, but the images that have some color require some modifications. So we are going to choose an image that requires some modification before we can use it. So as you can see, these images can be used directly in your coloring book pages. As you can see here, beautiful images are available here. So as you can see, all of these images can be used in your flower coloring book without any modifications. But let's choose something that have got some color in it. So let's search for, actually let's search for rare flowers. So what we can do is we can, let's use this image. Actually this looks pretty good and I think it will look good on a coloring book. So let's download this image and we are going to download vector graphic this time. So download the SVG format. So after your image gets downloaded, open a new tab and go to Gravit Designer. Gravit Designer is a web-based vector editing software and you can use this software for free. So let's just open the free Gravit Designer and let's just click this start now. So what we are going to do is create a new document of size of 8.5 by 11 inches and let's select inches here and hit create. So after this window opens up, simply go to this file tab and click on this open local file and select the downloaded file. So I will select this flower here that I have downloaded. So after this file opens up, you are going to remove the fill color and change the outline color to black so that the image looks colorable. So to do that, what you are going to do is simply select this fill color and you can select multiple fill color by pressing shift in your keyboard and selecting by your mouse. Just press shift and select all the fill colors here. And what you can do is you can simply go to this fills tab here and just double click it and make it white. So as you can see, everything changes to white. So now to change the border, what you are going to do is you are going to select the border here. So let's select the border and what we are going to do is we are going to change it to black. So as you can see, everything changes to black. So now we are going to do the same thing for the remaining elements. This is how your image looks after you have removed all the fill colors and changed the stroke to black. Now you are going to simply click on this file tab and select on this export tab here and select PNG. We are going to save it in the PNG format and we are going to name this file flower coloring book page 1. So let's just save it. So after you save your image, you can simply close this tab and go to, let's just leave it, and you can go to your Canva. After you come to Canva, go to this uploads tab and click on this upload media and select your file that you have exported from Gravit Designer. So now I can simply drag and drop this file here. So let's just zoom in. So now we can add various different elements in this flower to make it look more beautiful. So what you can do is go to this elements tab and search for different flowers. So let's add some flowers. So let's go to this graphic section here. So we can find various different elements. So let's use this element and let's change the color to black. Now let's add another element. Actually, you can see various different recommendations here. So let's use this image here. Let's turn it to black. So if you think your image, your border looks too dark, then what you can do is simply just change the color and make it a little bit more grayish so that it lightens up. So now it matches the color with other elements. Let's also add this element here. Let's change the color to black. This also looks too dark, so let's just change the color. Now let's add another element to our coloring book page. So let's go to this graphics section and let's add some simple hand-drawn objects. So let's use this circle here and let's change the color to black. So now we can simply fill various different places by using this circle. Let's reduce its size. Now what we can do is add some text to our coloring book page. So let's add something like, so I'm just adding a random quote here. And let's just go to this effects tab and make it hollow, and let's just increase the thickness to 60 to 70 points. Let's increase the font size a little bit, 44 45 46, looks good. Actually, let's make it 45 points. So now what we are going to do is add a simple frame here. To add the frame, we are going to go to this elements tab and search for a rectangle and simply add this rectangle with just borders in it and simply just align it. So as you can see, this beautiful flower coloring book page is ready. So similarly, you can create beautiful flower coloring pages. So as I said you earlier, I'm going to share with you a resource where you can download free vector images that you can use in your coloring book. So before sharing with you the free resource, I want to tell you about Creative Fabrica. If you guys don't know about Creative Fabrica, then Creative Fabrica has got some amazing graphics that you can use without any restrictions in your book. So make sure to check that out. And Creative Fabrica is literally very cheap. So I will provide you the link to Creative Fabrica down below in the description. So make sure to check that out. So let's head on to our free resource where you can get amazing graphics that you can use without any restrictions in your coloring book. And the website is called publicdomainvectors.org. So let's search for flowers in this website and let's see some of the images in this website. So as you can see, various different vector graphics are available and you can simply download these vector graphics and go to Gravit Designer and remove the colors and do various different things with these images. And all of these images can be used in your book without any restrictions. as you can see, various different awesome images are available. If you go to this website and take some time to look at various different images, you will definitely find some pretty good images that can be used in your coloring book page. So friends, I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. And as always, thank you for watching this video. Have a great day.